Hey folks, Tim here again. It's been about a week since I last recorded one of these vlogs, and what a difference a week makes. So right behind us, here's our pond here at the field school. You'll notice that it's ice free and you can't see any snow. There still is a little bit of snow in the woods in shady places, but for the most part we're snow free. And now we're really enjoying the warmer weather. So this is the first in a series where I want to talk about life at the field school or in another similar place with no infrastructure. So today, first off, I want to talk about bathing. So bathing is something, in order to learn well, sleep well, and not be a smelly, disgusting, horrible creature, we need to bathe regularly. So in the winter time, when we're out snowshoeing for weeks at a time, our bathing procedures consist of having a cook pot that will heat water up in and a washcloth. So you have your nice hot water, you dip, maybe you get a little alone time in the hot tent, dip, rinse off, wash off, and you're good to go. And that's about as simple as you could get bathing. So you can do that here at the field school during warmer weather as well. So when I was a kid, I grew up on a small lake, and now in the summertime as a grown up, when we're out canoeing for 4 weeks at a time, I'll go 4 weeks without soap touching my body, and it doesn't bother me at all because I swim every day. I'll swim in the pond here or in the river down the hill, and if we're out in the middle of nowhere canoeing, I'll be swimming on the rivers there. But if you use any sort of product, any soap, any shampoo, anything that smells, anything that's manufactured, it has no business going in ponds, lakes, rivers, or even the ocean from my perspective. So even though if you buy the fancy soap where it says you can use this, it's biodegradable, don't ever do that. Dilution is not the solution to pollution. So regardless of what the manufacturers tell you, that stuff has no business being in water that you're going to drink, and it has no business being in water where fish live that you want to catch and eat. So keep all that product, all that stuff out of there. So when people want to bathe here, have a hot shower, there's really two components that go into that shower. Number one is heating up the water. So for example, with the cook pot method, we'd heat the water in here. Sometimes we'll put out big blue or black plastic jugs, let them sit in the sun, and the solar heat will heat that water all day, and then you have a shower at the end of the day. So we have a dedicated shower enclosure here, and it's got a pulley system, so you can go in there and hang something, maybe something like this. It's a canvas bag with a shower on the bottom. I think it's an old military surplus thing that I got from a friend of mine. Thank you, Derek. So we can heat our water up, put it in this bag, hoist it up, and have a nice hot shower with all the soap and shampoo that you want. So that's one option. Another option is to get a dedicated solar shower bag, and those are made out of plastic. We don't have those here anymore because they really only last for about a month before you punch a hole in it. But that's another one where you will heat the water in the bag, then hang the bag and have your shower. So simplifying it. So my preferred method is this little beauty right here. So this is a pump up solar shower. It's a black plastic jug with a pump on it. And on the top here is a shower head. So I pump it and then I get a nice hot shower. This thing holds about 2.5 gallons. It's on the gear list, but I'll put it on the show notes for this episode. So you fill it with cold water in the morning, let it sit in the sun all day, and then in the afternoon it's heated and ready to go. So one of the benefits of the pump-up shower to the others is I don't need to have any infrastructure to hang this over my head. I can set it right on the ground, and this hose is long enough to get the top of my head. So I've had this thing, I don't know, 5 or 6 years. They still sell them. Now they sell them. They're orange, I think. And they're about 50 bucks, but it's 50 bucks well spent. So there's a principle here to living off-grid, and that is that if something's really a pain in the neck to do, you're probably not going to do it that often. So if in order to really get a good hot shower, I've got to heat up 15 of these pails, you know, 2 to get a pre-rinse, and then I soap up, and then, I don't know, 13 to rinse everything off, I'm probably not going to do it very often. So the beauty of the pump-up shower here is you can do it every day. And let's say you get a day where it's really cloudy out. I can easily pour hot water into this that maybe I heated on a stove, over a fire, or in some sort of solar container. So this is my method that I like to use here. I highly recommend that you figure something out, because you want to be able to bathe and get clean at least every other day, if not every day. That's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it.